Hey guys, welcome back to this SQL tutorial course. In this session, we will look at some string functions. So first we have the ltrim function, which helps in removing the blank spaces on the left side of the character expression. So let's implement this function in SQL Server. So let me first create a string with some blank spaces on the left side. So I'll type select, and then I will give some blank spaces on the left side. Now, let me pass in a string and I'll name the string to be Sparta. I'll hit execute. Right. So this is the string which has some leading spaces on the left side. Now, if I want to remove all of these blank spaces on the left side, all I need to do is use the ltrim function. So I will type select ltrim and inside this, I will pass in the string with the leading spaces. So I'll copy this and I will paste it over here. Now, let me execute both of this simultaneously, right? So this is the string with the leading spaces. And when we use the ltrim function, all of those blank spaces on the left side were removed. Then we have the lower function, which basically converts all the characters to the lower case. So let's look at an example. This time, let me actually print a string which has all the characters in capitals. So this is Sparta. So here we see that all of the characters in the string are in capitals. I'll execute this and this is what we get. Now if I want to convert all of the characters into lowercase, I can just use a lower function. So I will type select lower and then pass in the string inside the function. I'll copy the string. I will paste it inside this. I'll hit execute. So this is the string where all the characters were in capitals, and after using the lower function, this string where all the characters were in capitals have been turned to lowercase. Similarly, we have the upper function, which basically converts all the characters to uppercase. So this time I will take in a string which has all the characters in lowercase. So select, I will type hello world. Let me print this, right? So here we see that initially all of the characters are in lowercase. Now after this, I will type select upper and then pass in the string inside the function. I'll copy this. I will paste it over here. I'll hit execute. So this was our initial string. And after using the upper function, we have converted the string into capital case. After that, we have the reverse function, which basically reverses all the characters in the string. So let's implement this too. So let me take in a random string again. Select. And I will type I love ice cream. I'll hit execute. So this is what we get initially. Now after this, I will use the reverse function. Select reverse and I will pass in the string inside the reverse function. I'll copy it and I will paste it inside this function over here. Now let me execute. So this is the initial string, and after using the reverse function, we have reversed all of the characters in the string, right? So you see that this is the starting and this is the ending over here. And after reversing it, we get this final string. And finally, we have the substring function, which gives us a substring or part of the string from the original string. Now, let me give in the original string first. So I will type select and then the string would be this is Sparta. Now, let's say I would want this substring Sparta from this entire string. So this is where we can use the substring function. So I will type select substring. Now the substring function takes in three parameters. First is the original string. So I will copy the original string and I will pass it into this as the first parameter. Now after that, I need to give in the index value from where the substring starts. So this is the first character of the substring which I want. So the index value would be 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, and 9. So I'll type 9 over here. And then the third parameter would be the length of the substring. So the length of the substring is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. So I will pass in 6 over here. Now let me execute all of these and let's see what do we get. So this is the original string. This is Sparta. And after using the substring function, we have extracted only this part from the entire string. So these were some of the string functions in SQL. Thanks for attending this session. Let's meet in the next class.